Hi, everybody. I just got the MLS data for June for McCormick Ranch. So now I can do the second quarter for McCormick Ranch. And what I've been doing, I've been collecting data for quarters. With McCormick Ranch, it's not big enough. Month to month, there's huge differences. So what I do is I put the data into quarters and then I levels out the data a little bit so I can analyze it a little bit better. And let me show you this graph that I keep internally. I make it. And let's look at the sales down here. This is the number of sales per quarter. And let's kill that. For example, on this quarter, there was 25 homes sold. Total sales were 41, 25 were normal, and then the red is 16 were distressed sales. So the big number here, this line, so there's three lines. This is total. Normal is blue, and then distressed are these. So you can see that there's a pretty solid straight upward trend from the peak to peak. There's the second quarter is always the strongest quarter, and then it levels off. But there's a dang good straight line there through the 2012 second quarter. But this second quarter, we fell for the first time. So every year, one, two, three, years increasing in the second quarter this year, it went down a little bit. So I think this price increase, the red here is the price increase for non-distressed sales. The green, not the price increase, the red is the median price. Actually, it's the average price for non-distressed sales, and the green is the average price for distressed sales. So you can see prices went up a lot on the second quarter here, and then we got unexpected, I didn't expect it, but the third quarter and fourth quarter last year, we had big price increases. And then it's kind of leveled off since then. Typically, we'd see more price increases in the first and second quarter, but prices have gotten so high that the price increases are starting to level off. And the sales are not increasing anymore. Certainly, they may be leveling off. Declined a little bit here, but I'd like to see more months. But you can see here that this quarter, the third quarter, there were fewer sales in the third quarter of 2011, and in the fourth quarter of 2012, sales were less than in the fourth quarter of 2011. But then again, you see prices were going up as well. So let's talk about what's happening with distressed sales. Distressed sales, that's a pretty straight line fall there. We're down to seven in the second quarter of this year, 2013. We're not going to have a big decline in distressed sales like we've had in the past. We're down to seven in the quarters, as high as 25. So that's a big factor which will help make prices go up. But on the other hand, we're going to have those distressed sales or forced sales, or the sellers are not choosing to sell. They're being forced to sell. They're forced sales. But that's going down to it's so small. So if we went to seven to three, that's not going to have a big effect, even if it fell in half at this point, have a minor effect. But what I expect to see is that there will be more normal sales hitting the market. A lot of sellers are going to realize, hey, my home's worth a lot more than I thought. I could sell the thing and makes a little bit of money. And I think we'll start seeing those. But the fact that prices seem to be leveling off a little bit here. There was very little difference between the first quarter and the second quarter that we may be reaching a. I don't expect them to increase as much next year as they did this year or the previous year. And in fact, they could level off, but I think they'll just go up a smaller, much smaller amount. So anyway, that's my guess what's going to happen to the market. If you're a home seller in McCormick Ranch, I think we've got the sweet spot has already been taken care of as far as increases go. There might be a little bit more increases. We have huge doubts what's going to happen on the demand side because interest rates are going up. So it could be that as interest rates go up, that people can't. If you're a buyer, you have to pay higher interest rate. You have to get a cheaper home. You can't qualify for an expensive home at 3.6% interest rate as you can at 4.6. So you're gonna have to get cheaper homes. So that could affect some buyers. You're gonna have a lot fewer multiple offers. It's gonna be tougher. It's gonna be more of a slugfest for sellers next year than it was. This year or last year. So that's where I'm coming from. So listen, if you want to sell your McCormick Ranch home, I would love to help you do that. I live here in McCormick Ranch, love the place, and I'm great at marketing homes online, and I'm great at analyzing the value of your home. Great. So I'm John Wake. If you like this, please subscribe to my YouTube channel for McCormick Ranch, or you can, or if you do Facebook or Twitter, if you could share this post, I'd appreciate it as well very much. Great. Oh, or call me if you have any questions too. I appreciate calls from people who live in McCormick Ranch or elsewhere, just to find out what's going on in the market here. Great. I'm starting to ramble. Thanks for listening. Take care.